Hello everyone, in this video we have two semicircle. Radius of the yellow semicircle is given 1 and radius of the blue semicircle is given 3, and then these are given as center point and here as tangent point, and then tangent alpha is asked. Okay. First step, we know that here is tangent chord angle, right? So if it is alpha, that means this arc must be equal to alpha, right? Therefore, if we connect center with tangent point like this, here must be equal 90 degrees, right? And then here is center angle, so this angle must be equal to alpha. And we know that straight angle equals 180 degrees, right? So 180 minus 2 alpha left here. Okay. And here is radius of the blue semicircle, right? Here is radius as well, and this length is also radius. Likewise, if here's 1, that means here is also 1 unit. And then notice that we know this side and height patterns, right? Therefore, if we calculate cosine 180 minus 2 alpha, we get 3 over 5. Right? 3 over 5. Okay. And we know that cosine 180 minus 2 alpha equal minus cosine 2 alpha. You have to know this. This is very important. Okay. Let's go ahead. So this expression equal minus cosine 2 alpha equal 3 over 5. That means cosine 2 alpha equal minus 3 over 5. Okay. And then the expansion of cosine 2 alpha equal 1 minus 2 times sine squared alpha. Okay. If you plug in this value to the equation, so 1 minus 2 times sine squared alpha equal minus 3 over 5. Therefore, 1 plus 3 over 5 equal 2 times sine squared alpha. So 5 plus 3 over 5 equal 2 times sine squared alpha. That means 8 over 5 equal 2 times sine squared alpha. Let's simplify. So sine squared alpha equal 4 over 5. Let's square root both sides of the equation. So sine alpha equal 2 over root 5. Right? So now let's draw the right triangle. And let's call here alpha. You know that here is 2 and hypotenuse is root 5. Let's call here y. Therefore, if you apply Pythagorean theorem, 2 squared plus y squared equal root 5 whole squared. So 4 plus y squared equal 5. Y squared equal 1. That means y equal 1 unit. Let's write here 1. Therefore, tangent alpha equal 2 over 1. So tangent alpha is going to be 2. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and